Hi.
Hey, how are you? Thanks for taking a few minutes. I know we tried to catch up with you last week, but you had a workout to do, so thanks for hopping on this week.
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that.
What's going on with this mainland soccer program? Both the boys and the girls just having incredible seasons.
Oh, yeah, of course. We're picking up from last season because last season were both strong seasons, but this year we had new goals farther than just the Cal, farther than, like, qualifying for things, and I think we're really, like, pushing towards that. And same with the guys, too, like, to for them to get South jerseys again and for us to make it that far, too.
Who's better, the boys' team or the girls' team?
We can't ask that.
You're declined to answer that question?
So it's a different side of the play.
We'll just say you're equally as good.
Oh, yeah.
Tell me about this defense, particularly for the mainland girls. You guys won 10 straight games at one point without letting up a goal, 50-0 goal differential. That's just an incredible stat to think of. I don't even know if you guys knew that.
Oh, yeah. It, like, kind of hit us when we were, like, looking at the record boards and seeing, like, how long our team went without getting goals shut on them. But our defense, we played together last year, like, and we've always had this thing that we go, like, waves upon waves. Like, if someone gets beat, the next person's right on them. And, like, we just have this wave process that we're, like, basically a brick wall back there. Like, we always have each other's back, and we know how each other's play. So it's, like, everything works out together.
I saw you guys, I believe it was last week, and what impressed me the most was just your efficiency throughout the midfield. The other teams don't really have a chance to possess the ball too much, and you guys are all about – you know, keeping possession, working the ball up the field, and getting good shots, and it seems like everything's working for you guys.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely our game. Like, if anything, we always calm down and just possess the ball. We don't need to force anything because, like, when we're possessing it through the midfield and switching fields, it gets other teams frustrated, and then that's when we have our scoring opportunities.
So, Molly, how famous is Angelina Blanchett now that she was on the cover of Glory Days magazine?
Oh, so famous. I've got to give her a crutch. And last night she did an amazing job. And even though we did break our shutout streak, it still goes to show that team was a really good team and we were able to bounce back and get two goals to win.
Yeah, well, now's the point of the season where you're really going to start getting tested. Obviously, you had a big game about a week and a half ago against Egg Harbor Township, won that game, and Clearview yesterday took you into overtime. You guys were able to win that game. Where do you guys feel like you're at now, and what are you guys working on as we get into late October here?
Well, like, and the Cal, obviously, there's not as many teams that are challenging us, so last night was great to help us keep working because, obviously, like, harder teams are coming, so we have to remember in those type of games to keep our cool and not get stressed out, even when they score first or we are breaking down in defense. Because, like our coach said to us before the game, forget about the, I think it was 11-game shutout streak. Forget about it. If they score, all our offense will score two more. And that's the mentality that we have of, like, a team. If one person fails, the next person can pick it up right there.
We're talking with Molly O'Shea from the Mainland Regional Girls Soccer Team. And, Molly, one thing I've noticed about this team is you guys really seem to get along. You have a lot of experience playing soccer together and just seem like a really good friends on and off the field. And how important is that to have that team chemistry?
Team chemistry is honestly key in going far together because everybody understands each other and what they're going through. And we always have little team gatherings after practice, like pasta parties. And we also have been growing up with each other and playing rec soccer since we were so young. So that is, like, key to understanding how each other play, and then we, like, work together so well on the field. It just transfers on and off.
One of the things that I found interesting when I was talking to Coach Weidman and Coach Mead, they were saying that you guys work out with the boys over the summer, maybe a couple times a week, go against them. How much has that helped you going against boys teams in preseason? Those guys are so good, and really, I'm sure they challenged you all summer. How much of a better soccer team did that make you guys?
Yeah, three times a week we would play futsal with them, and, like, we would be able to experience that fast play and aggressive play that we, like, will be seeing, and we have seen, like, for a couple teams like Clearview last night, and that really set the tone and prepared us. Like, teams are going to be like this, and we need to be able to compete. And so Wyman was always ready to challenge us, and our girls would make it to the top courts in futsal, and like, because we practice so much with them, and we are able to be that aggressive in that level of play.
Have the boys earned a little bit of respect for the girls' team?
I think we're both, like, working off each other here, like, because a lot of the things in Mainland right now is, like, how good our girls and boys soccer team is going right now, and our night games are always packed with people. So, like, I think we can both take a little credit for each other.
Talking with Molly O'Shea from Mainland Regional Girls Soccer. And Molly, is there a little bit of good natured trash talking going on in the hallways of school, like the boys saying how good they are, and you guys countering back with, hey, we haven't let up a goal since the season opener?
Always. In gym class, I have a bunch of my guy friends in there, and they're like, oh, well, we did this. And I'm like, well, we had an 11 game shutout streak. And it's just like bickering back and forth. And it's just like great, funny chemistry that we have.
How cool is that, Molly, to have that much excitement about the soccer programs in school?
It's great because I know a lot of programs are all focused on like football and like other guy sports, and to have a girl sport and like a soccer, both teams have so much like recognition and credit is just amazing.
Good stuff, Molly. We'll keep it going. Keep working hard. We'll let you get rolling, and you probably have a workout to get done this morning, but we appreciate you taking a few minutes with us.
Yeah, nice talking to you.
Thanks. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
Bye. That was Molly O'Shea from Mainland Regional High School girls soccer team, having an incredible season. Only one loss that came in the season opener. And, Cole, they've only let up 3 goals the entire season in, I believe, 12 or 13 games. So one of the best soccer teams in South Jersey.